This video is going to be about finding the nth term of a geometric sequence. So let's get started. Here I've got this number sequence, 5, 10, 20, 40, and then the ellipsis, the three dots that mean the sequence keeps going. And looking at it, I realize it's a geometric sequence because I keep getting a new term by multiplying the previous term by the same number. In other words, I take a 5 and get the next term by multiplying by 2 to get 10. The 10 gets multiplied by 2 into a 20 for the next term, then multiply by 2 again and get a 40. So it's geometric, and its common ratio, the number I'm multiplying by, is 2. So I'm going to write r equals 2 so I can remember the common ratio. And what if somebody asks me, what's term number 11? Well, one way I could do this is to keep multiplying by 2 until I find out what the 11th term is. But let's find a general way to do it. So I'm going to set up a table. I'll make two columns. The first column, I'm going to write what the number of the term, like 1, 2, and 3. But I'm going to use a slightly different notation. Instead of 1, I'm going to write a sub 1. And instead of 2, I'm going to write a sub 2. And instead of 3 for the third term, I'll write a sub 3, and so on. And then the second column, I'll write what that term is. So the first term, a sub 1, is a 5. The second term, a sub 2, is 10. But I get that 10 by multiplying the 5 by the common ratio. So let's just write 5 times 2. Now if I take that term and multiply it by the common ratio, I'll get the third term. So that would be 5 times 2 times 2 again. In the same way, the fourth term, a sub 4, is going to be 5 times 2 times 2 times 2. Now, instead of writing all of these 2s, I can use an exponent. So I can take that fourth term, 5 times 2 times 2 times 2, and write that more simply as 5 times 2 to the third power. The term before that would be 5 times 2 to the second power. The term before that, which is just 5 times 2, using an exponent, I'll write that as 5 times 2 to the first power. And if I want to keep using exponents, the first term will be 5 times 2 to the zero power, since 2 or any number to the zero power is just 1. And now if I look at this, I see there's a relationship between the number of the term and the exponent that I'm using. For term number 1, a sub 1, my exponent is 0. For term number 2, my exponent is 1. For term 3, a sub 3, the exponent is 2. So what I'm doing is I'm taking the number of the term, subtracting 1 from it, and making that the exponent that I use to raise my 2, or common ratio to. So that means if I want to find whatever term, let's call that term number n, or the nth term, what I'm going to do is set that equal to 5 times 2, and my exponent is 1 less than the number of the term. If the number of the term is n, then the exponent is n minus 1. Okay, so now I've got a general rule here for this sequence. And if I want to find term number 11, well, all I'll do is replace the n with an 11. So that means I can take that as 5 times 2 to the 11 minus 1. 11 minus 1 is 10, so that's 5 times 2 to the 10th. 2 to the 10th is 1024, so 5 times 1024. And now if I multiply 5 times 1024, let's see. Well, 5 times 1,000 is 5,000, and 5 times the 24 is 120. So term number 11, or a sub 11, would be 5,120. So now that I've got a rule for this sequence, let's see if we can make a rule for any sequence. So let's see what we did. We said that the nth term was 5, which was actually the first term, times 2, which was the common ratio, raised to the power n minus 1. So let's, instead of writing 5 for the first term, let's just say a sub 1. Remember, that's what we called our first term. And then instead of writing 2, which was the common ratio, let's write r, the letter we're using for the common ratio. And then the exponent is going to be n minus 1, the number of the term we want, minus 1. So a general rule for finding the nth term of a geometric sequence would be a sub 1, the first term, times r, the common ratio, raised to the power n minus 1. So if you're given a geometric sequence and you're asked to find some term, you can just plug the numbers you have for the sequence into this general formula, and you get that term. And that's about it. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.